Hallelujah. 奉耶稣圣名正道。
Hallelujah. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I share a message.
感谢真神再次带领我们在他的神的家、神的殿来启开天国福音的步道。
Thanks be our true God. Today we can be in God's house once again to share the gospel.
再次的感谢亲戚朋友到来参加一同敬拜。
I'd like to once again thank our friends and family members to come and worship with us.
愿真神天父祝福你也带领你。
May the true God, our Heavenly Father, bless you and guide you.
我们祈求主耶稣与我们同在。
We ask our Lord Jesus to be with us.
晚上这堂布道会的分享的信息是永恒的应许。
The message I'd like to share with you this evening is the eternal promise.
主耶稣不但给我们永恒的救赎。
Our Lord Jesus not only gave us eternal salvation,
他给我们许多很宝贵的永恒的应许。
He also gave us many precious eternal promises.
亲爱的朋友
，Dear friends,
我们人生有许多的承诺。
We make many promises in life.
有些是我们给别人的承诺。
Sometimes we offer these promises to others.
有些是别人给我们的承诺。
Sometimes other people give us their promise.
但是在我们的生命当中，我们有许多不能实现的承诺。
But in our lives, there are many promises that are unfulfilled.
因为我们的能力有限。
Because our strength is limited.
因为我们的生命有限。
Because our life is limited.
种种的各种原因。
For one reason or another.
常常使我们的承诺变成一场空的承诺。
Our promises often turn out to be empty.
这种空的承诺造成了许多的误会。
Empty promises produce many kinds of misunderstandings.
这种空的承诺也伤害了不少的人。
And empty promises have hurt a lot of people.
甚至也伤害了自己。
And they have hurt ourselves.
世间上其实没有一个人能够给予永恒的承诺。
No one in this world can offer eternal promises.
因为我们人会死。
Because we as men must die.
因为我们人会变。
As human beings, we change.
当我们的心一变的时候，我们的人一变的时候，变得非常的快。
When our hearts change, when we change, the change is very sudden.
你所承诺的，你所讲的海誓山盟，你所发誓的，所启示的，全部都空了。
All your former promises, all the swearings you've made, are gone.
今天我们要讲的是永恒的承诺。
But today, I'd like to talk about eternal promises.
永恒就是不变。
Eternal means that it's unchanging.
会变的就不是永恒。
Something that changes is not eternal.
不变的才有价值。
Only what is unchanging is valuable.
这种不变的承诺是主耶稣给我们的承诺。
This unchanging promise is from our Lord Jesus.
因为主耶稣是永恒的，他是不改变的。
Because our Lord Jesus is eternal, he does not change.
所以主耶稣给我们的应许全一切都是一种永恒的承诺，不改变的承诺。
All of Jesus' promises to us are eternal and unchanging.
那到底耶稣给我们怎样的承诺呢
？What kind of promises did Jesus offer us？
请大家看，翻开《约翰福音书》第十四章。
Please turn to John chapter 14.
约翰福音书十四章二十七节。
John chapter 14 verse 27.
请念。
Verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you.Not as the world gives to you, I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid.
从这里我们看到主耶稣允许要给我们平安。
Our Lord Jesus promised to give us peace.
他说他留下平安给我们。
He leaves his peace with us.
并且他说他要给我们的平安，要赐给我们的平安，是跟世人的平安不一样的。
And the peace he gives to us is not as the world gives.
为什么主耶稣在这里要给我们平安呢？
Why does the Lord Jesus give us peace?
主耶稣知道我们心里的痛苦。
He knows the pain within our hearts.
他知道我们心里的恐惧。
He knows the fear within us.
所以他在这里对门徒说：“你们心里不要忧愁。”
So he tells the believers not to be troubled.
你们心里更加不要害怕，不要胆怯。
Let not your heart be troubled or be afraid.
在这个风雨的人生里面。
In this life of storms,
有太多的事情让我们不能不担心。
There are so many things that make us worried.
有太多恐怖的事情。让我们不能不恐不害怕。
There are many things that terrify us.
主耶稣了解我们的担心，了解我们的忧愁。
Our Lord Jesus knows our troubles and our grief.
所以他说我们心里不要忧愁。
So he tells us, let not our hearts be troubled.
心里的忧愁是真正的忧愁。
The trouble of the heart is true trouble.
其他的病生病伤风感冒我们吃药就可以医好的。
Illnesses can usually be cured.
但是心里的忧愁。 谁能够医治啊？
But the sorrow of the heart, who can heal?
心里的忧愁，你吃药可以解决吗？
Can taking medicine cure the trouble of your heart?
主耶稣了解我们的痛苦，了解我们的担忧。
Our Lord Jesus knows our sorrows and our grief.
他说他要给我们平安。
He promises to give us peace.
这种忧愁，这种胆怯，这种恐惧，就是因为心中没有平安。
We feel troubled and afraid because we do not have peace in our
hearts. 虽然我们周围有很多的朋友，有很多的很多的亲人。
We may have many friends and family members.
我们甚至也有很多的钱。
We may have a lot of money.
可是心里还是恐惧的。
But our hearts may still be afraid.
这种恐惧不是一种外表，不是一种世界的这种拥有而得到的。
This fear cannot is not through the possessions of this world.
那主耶稣要给的平安啊，是不是世上的平安？
The peace that Jesus gives is not as the world gives.
世人认为的平安就是我健康，我身体健康。
To the people of this world, peace means health.
那我头脑又非常不错。
Intelligence.
那然后我有一些钱，甚至不少的钱。
Wealth.
那我又可以吃，可以睡。
And being able to eat and sleep.
没有缺乏。
Nothing lacking.
那这个就是平安哦。
To the people of this world, this is peace.
请问这些是平安吗？
But is this really peace?
这当然是平安。
Yes, it is peace.
但是这种平安不是真正的平安来的。
But this is not true peace.
你说你有健康。
You may say, I have good health.
你能够保证你永远健康啊。
But can you guarantee that you'll be healthy forever?
你今天健康，明天呢？
You may be healthy today. What about tomorrow?
你今天身体很好，明年呢？
What about next year?
其实很多人不敢去看医生的，不敢去检查的。
Some people are afraid to go to the doctor for a visit.
特别是我们做丈夫、做男人的，都不想去看医生的。
The man, the husband, dares not go to see the doctor.
但是一看呢，哎呦，这个又痛，那个又痛，一看呢，这个要开刀，那个要开刀。
Because every time you go to the doctor, there are some health issues, health problems. You have to go to surgery.
不看自己都觉得自己很好。
If you don't go to the doctor, you may feel healthy.
检查我们知道我们的健康。我们的健康 是没有保障的，没有把握的。
But once you go for a checkup, you realize that your health is not that.
你说你有钱是吗
？Stable, and you may say you're wealthy.
你有钱你就没有缺乏是吗？不担心是吗？
Would you say that you have nothing to be afraid of?
但是钱是最无情的，你也知道钱是最无情的。
But money is without mercy.
他要走的时候就走的，不会跟你说拜拜的。
When money leaves you, it will not say goodbye.
他也不会说同情你啊，留下一些钱给你的。他走都走到干干净净，五分钱都没有的，一分钱都没有的。
Money has no sympathy. When your money is gone, you have nothing left.
一场灾难，一场意外，一场大火，会让我们这些都改变的。
Just one tragedy or disaster, you may lose everything.
因为我们所说的平安，那不是真的平安。
So the so-called peace in this world is not true peace.
那是一种暂时的，你感觉到的一种暂时的平安，但是是不稳定的。
It is only a temporary feeling of peace, which is not lasting.
耶稣说，他要给我们的平安不是这样的。
But Jesus tells us that the peace he leaves us with is not like
this. 他要给我们的平安是在风雨中的平安。
But the peace he gives us is the peace in storms.
甚至病痛、灾难来到的时候，我们仍然心里非常的平安的。
Even when we are faced with illness and trouble, we can still feel that peace.
甚至更可怕的死亡临到的时候，面临的时候，仍然是心中很平静的。
Even when death arrives at our door, we can still feel peace.
可以让我们用笑容、用喜乐的去面对这一切。
We can face all these things with a smile.
如果内心没有真正的平安，没有办法有这样的笑容。
Without true peace in our hearts, we can never do that.
主耶稣要给的就是这样的平安。
And this is the peace that Jesus wants to give us.
在风雨中的平安。
The peace in times of storm.
顺顺利利、平平安安，大家都会讲。都会讲平安啊。
When life is good, it's easy to talk about peace.
但是这种人世间的风雨啊，实在很难让我们预测的。
But the weather, the things in this life are really unpredictable.
那有一次那个画展比赛，画家画展比赛。
There was a painting competition.
那主题就是临近平安，临近与平安。
And the theme of the competition was to paint something that's serene and peaceful.
很多画家就画出了那种很宁静、很平安的那种画面。
So many artists painted pictures of a scene that's very calm and peaceful.
有一个画家，他就画了一个农夫带着喜乐的笑容 回家了，刚做他的锄头回家了。
One artist painted a farmer going home happily after a long day's work.
这时候太阳西下，倦鸟归巢，景色非常的美丽。
The sun is setting and the birds returning to their nests is very beautiful.
这个图画呢，要呈现的就是说，这个人他过着一种很平凡、很安详、很宁静的生活。
So the painting portrays a life that's very tranquil and peaceful.
他尽他的力量，一天的责任去做工，做完工了就回家，很平静，很喜乐。
The farmer has worked hard the whole day, and he is now returning home with joy.
这当然也是一种平静跟一种平安的一种画面。
And that presents a picture of tranquility.
啊，但是拿奖的不是这样的图画。
But he did not earn first place.
刚好拿奖的是另一种哦。完全不同的那种画面。
The artist that got first place painted something very different.
那讲的画面是个海浪、哦、很汹涌，风暴很汹涌的那个画面。
In the painting, he painted a storm on the sea.
在海岸上有一棵大树。
And then on the shore, there was a tree.
大树伸出的树干、哦、伸出到海滩那边。
And from this tree extends a branch that over the sea.
那树干上有一只鸟窝。
And on the branch was a nest.
鸟窝上有两只小鸟正在安睡。
And there are two birds resting
quietly. 小鸟在那个大风浪当中，在风暴当中，在那个鸟窝里面安睡。
In the nest, in the midst of a big storm.
整个环境都是风雨来的。
The entire surroundings is filled with storm.
可是两只小鸟，小小哦，很脆弱的小鸟，却在那边很平静的、很安详的睡觉。
But the two little birds are able to sleep quietly inside the storm.
结果这样的画面呢、啊，这幅画拿第一名呢、啊。
And this painting won first place.
因为它所呈现出来的是真正什么叫做真正的宁静，什么叫做真正的平安。
Because it really captures what it means to have true peace.
这才是真正的平安、啊。
This is true peace.
在暴风雨当中仍能够安睡。
In the midst of a great storm, that the birds can still sleep in peace.
主耶稣给的平安就是这样。
This is the kind of peace that Jesus
gives. 这个也是我们每一个基督徒应该有的见证。
And this should be the testimony of every
Christian. 虽然我们信仰的人生当中有很多的风浪、哦、汹涌的海浪。
Our lives may be filled with waves and storms.
那说起来是很可怕的。
Which are very terrifying.
可是你看海的深处 在海的最深处是平静的。
But if you go to the bottom of the ocean, there's not a single ripple.
海里的深海中的鱼、啊、在那边很平静的悠游，在那边快乐的悠游。
The different fishes at the bottom of the ocean floor are
可是海面上是可怕的。
But above the sea, on the surface, it is very scary.
耶稣说：“我要留下平安给你们。”
Jesus says, "I will give my peace to you."
我将我的平安赐给你们。
I give my peace. I give to you.
我所赐给你们的不像世人所赐的。
Not as the world gives, do I give to you.
这个就是世人不一样的平安呐、啊。
This
风雨中的平安呐、
啊。Peace that differs from that of the world. Peace in storms.
我们这位有位姐妹，她当时还没有信主。
We have a sister in our church.Before she was a believer,
她心里、哦、没有平安、啊、
She used to have no peace at all.
她每一天都在恐惧，都在害怕。
She lived in constant fear.
哦，大白天哦，太阳很闷热，她也在害怕。
Even in the middle of the day, when there's sunlight out there, she was afraid.
她不能够看到黑的东西。
She was so scared of the dark.
看到黑的东西，她会喊叫起来，会更加的害怕。
Whenever she saw something dark, she would scream.
但是你在一天生活里面，总不可能没有遇到黑的东西吧？
But in your daily life, it's impossible to avoid anything that's dark.
现在的人啊，朋友啊，公司的职员啊，喜欢穿黑袍啊，黑衣啊。
Nowadays,
怎么样？
Our friends or our co-workers like to dress in black.
啊，有时你走路一条黑猫，黑色的，跑过，怎么样？
Sometimes you see a black cat running on the street.
有时黑狗，黑色的狗。
Or a black dog.
你避免不了，你总会遇到黑的啦。
You can't avoid seeing anything dark or
black. 所以她很痛苦啊。
So she was in such pain.
晚上睡觉一定要开灯啊，整个家里楼上到楼下全部开到光。
When she sleeps at night, she has to make sure all the lights in the house are lit.
然后在房间开到光，开灯，开到了后还要拿被单盖住自己，还要在那边怕。
It was so bright that she had to cover herself with a blanket, but even then she was still afraid.
纵使有人陪着她睡觉，家人陪她睡觉，她还是在怕。
And even when her family members slept next to her, she was scared.
你不要小看这种恐惧啊，会让一个人精神崩溃啊。
don't think little of this kind of fear. It can really disintegrate
someone. 所以这样一个人没有办法好好安静的生活，没办法。
Because the person cannot have a normal life.
所以他也是很痛苦。
She was in such great pain.
一直吃那些镇静药啊，让自己安静下来，平静下来，没办法。
Kept taking pills to calm herself down.
这种药吃太多，自己也有副作用，也有另一种问题出现。
But pills had side effects.
她心中没有平安。
She had no peace.
心中黑暗，没有神的光，没有光明在里面。
Her heart was filled with darkness. There was no light.
知道她来到我们真教会。
But she came to our true church.
哦，经过祷告聚会，哦，听道理。
After attending the service and praying,
慢慢很认识了这位真神
and listening to the word, she came to know the truth.
她感受到教会里面的平安
She felt the peace in the church.
后来主耶稣赐她平安
and the Lord Jesus gave her peace.
她整个这种恐惧、这种忧愁消失了
All her fears and sorrows vanished.
哦，现在自己一个人敢睡觉了
Now she can sleep alone.
而且她还洗，有时还穿黑衣呢
And sometimes she wears black.
传道笑她，哎。你敢穿黑衣啦
So now the preacher teases her and say, "Now you're not scared of the dark, huh?"
她怎么讲啊
And what does she say?
她说穿到黑色酷啊
She said, "Black color, the black is black clothes are cool."
她心里已经有主的平安了
Because she has the peace of the Lord
是真正的平安啊
This is true peace.
当然不再害怕这些东西
She's no longer scared of these things.
我们教会还有很多这种平安的见证
We have many other such testimonies in our church
about peace. 我们的信仰哦，信仰不是叫我们去逃避灾难，不是。
Our faith does not make us escape from our troubles.
信仰是让我们去面对灾难，进入灾难里面，去活出平安的见证。
Faith enables us to face our troubles and enter into our troubles and live our living testimony.
并不是一天到晚说啊，不要遇到这个，不要遇到那个，不要。
Instead of being afraid all the time.
人生不可能不遇到风雨的。
You can't avoid troubles and storms in life.
这个人生就是一场风雨的人生来的。
This life is a life of storm.
信仰就是给我们力量。
But faith gives us strength.
信仰就是给我们平安。
Faith gives us peace.
在没有平安的时候，在恐惧的时候，在灾难的时候，我们活出那种平安的那种信仰，平安的那种见证。
In times of trouble and danger, we can live out a testimony of peace.
所以弟兄姐妹
，brothers and sisters，
亲爱的朋友
，dear friends，
信仰不是叫我们逃避灾难哦。
Faith does not make us escape from our troubles.
信仰是让我们面对灾难的。
Faith enables us to face it.
这是主耶稣给的平安，让平安，让我们不怕灾难，不怕任何的风雨。
So this kind of peace makes us not afraid of any troubles and storms.
平时我们平安的时候，有钱，没有生病，没有灾难，我们不觉得平安是可贵的。
When life is smooth, we feel that we have everything and we don't treasure this peace.
有谁会觉得平安很可贵呢？
People in such lifestyle don't feel the necessity.
太阳每天都上来下去，上来下去，这种很平凡的、很平安的这种运作，谁会觉得很珍惜呢？谁会觉得是很感恩呢？
They see the sun rises and sets, day after day, and they don't really, they just take the peace for granted.
我们今天在平安当中，所以你没有感觉到平安的重要。
Because when you live in times of peace, you don't feel the importance of peace.
当有一天你失去平安的时候，你没有了平安的时候，你才知道原来平安是这么样的重要，非常的重要。
But one day when your good life is taken from you, then you will realize how important peace is.
这些失去平安的人，他才能够体会的。
Those who have lost their security will feel that.
人生不是一直讲要拿第一名啊，人生不是一直讲要很多钱啊，不是啊。
So life is not just about earning the first place or earning a lot of money all the time.
人生最重要是要平安，是最基本的平安，才可以安安静静的，才可以平平静静的生活啊，生活啊。
The most important part of life is to have peace to lead a normal life.
可是今天我们太多平安了，所以不觉得是。平安重要。
But today life may be so good that we don't feel the peace.
可是你不觉得平安，你不觉得平安重要？但是你又怕灾难，难道又一直在担心，一直在恐惧
？And at the same time, we're anxious about the possibility of danger or trouble.
在平安的时候就一直怕这个怕那个，怕到自己忧郁症，怕到自己哦不懂怎么样生活。
Even before trouble comes, we are already worried and afraid.
其实这种状态就说明你心中已经没有平安了，开始失去平安了。
And that fear tells you that you don't have peace in your heart.
这时候我们就需要主耶稣的平安。
And that is why we need the peace from our Lord Jesus.
内心是很平静、很稳定的。
To give us a sense of stability and calmness in our heart.
所以让我们继续可以很平安的生活，很很很 很实在的生活，实实在在的生活，快快乐乐的生活。
So that we can lead a very grounded and happy life.
啊，平安是重要的。
So this is the importance of peace.
而且主给的平安又是这么不同的平安。
And the peace that Jesus gives is so different.
那是更加的重要。
How precious is that peace?
耶稣说他要给我们。
And this is the promise from our Lord Jesus.
我们来看这个样福音书十六章。
Let's now turn to John chapter 16.
十六章，我们来读三十三节。
John chapter 16, verse 33.
请念。
Verse 33. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world.
耶稣在这里讲一句很实在的话，很真实的话。
Here Jesus makes a very true statement.
请你注意看哦。
Pay attention.
耶稣说，在世上你们有苦难哦。
In the world you will have tribulation.
但你们可以放心。
But be of good cheer.
我已经胜了世界。
I have overcome the world.
耶稣没有承诺我们天天天蓝，耶稣没有这样的承诺。
Jesus did not promise blue skies every day.
有些人传福音的时候传得太好，太理想，太美丽了，信耶稣啊，平安啊，信耶稣没有灾难，信耶稣不会生病，信耶稣什么？哇，讲到好像信耶稣都没有灾难，没有风雨的啦。
Some people preach saying that if you believe in Jesus, you will have good health, you will have no trouble.
谁跟你做这种承诺呀？
But who made these promises?
耶稣根本没有给我们这样的承诺啊。
Our Lord Jesus never gave such promises.
耶稣自己还说哦，你们在世上有苦难啊。
The Lord himself said you will have tribulation in the world.
每个人都要面对这种世上的苦难的。
Every one of us must face such tribulation.
虽然有苦难，但是我们放心。
But despite the tribulation, we can be at peace. We don't have to be afraid.
因为主耶稣与我们同在。
Because our Lord Jesus is with us.
主耶稣可以做我们灾难中的依靠。
He can be our reliance in our trouble.
并且他给我们那种灾难中的平安。
He can give us peace in tribulation.
他说我已经胜了世界。
He said I have overcome the world.
如果主耶稣在这个世界失败在这个世界，那他再大的承诺也没有用啊。
If the Lord Jesus had failed in this world, none of his promises would matter.
他还告诉我们要背起十字架来跟从他。
He even commanded us to carry our cross to follow him.
十字架就是一种苦难的路，苦难来的。
The cross represents suffering.
我们有时传福音哦，传的太不真实了。
Sometimes we may preach a gospel that is far from reality.
其实耶稣没有答应我们天天天蓝，不会生病，没有这样的承诺。
Our Lord Jesus did not promise us a blue sky every day.
每个人都会生病，都会有苦难的。
Everyone will go through sickness and trouble.
只是你的苦难是大苦难，是小苦难。
Some tribulations are greater than others.
但是我们就在这种苦难中学习活出我们的信仰，依靠那种信心。
But through these tribulations, we need to learn to live our faith.
这是我们要去面对的，要去接受的事情。
This is something we must face and accept.
神是我们的依靠。
God is our help.
主耶稣给我们平安的应许。
He has promised us peace.
比如说，你们放心。
Be of good cheer.
那主耶稣又给我们讲的应许呢？
What other promise did Jesus give?
我们看《约翰福音》十四章。
Let's read John chapter 14.
我们读一节到二节。
Verses 1 and 2.
请念。
Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you.
这里主耶稣承诺要应许给我们永恒的天家。
Here our Lord Jesus promised to give us an eternal home in heaven.
再一次的，他安慰我们心里不要忧愁。
Once again, he comforts us and tells us not to be troubled in our hearts.
你看，在主耶稣每一次的应许当中，他都先叫我们心里不要忧愁。
We can see how Jesus always tells us, "Let not your heart be troubled."
因为我们这个人生啊，今天这个人生太多的苦难，太多的忧愁了。
Because our life is filled with sorrow and trouble.
太多的破碎悲伤的事情。
There are too many brokenness and too much brokenness and trouble.
所以啊，请问有眼睛的人，请问有哪一个没有流过眼泪的？
Those of you who have eyes, which of you have never shed tears?
请问有心的人哦，有心的人，请问有哪一个没有伤心过的？
Those of you who have a heart, which of you have never felt heartache?
请问我们有气息的人，请问有哪一个没有叹息过的？请问有哪一个没有叹息过的？
Those of you who have a breath in you, Which of you have never sighed?
这说明我们的人生有许多的破碎跟悲伤。
This tells us how much brokenness and sorrow there is in the world.
再次安慰我们，不要忧愁。
So the Lord Jesus tells us not to be troubled.
你们信神也应当信我。
He said, "You believe in God, believe also in me."
更何况我们今天世人所信的神不是神来的，不是真正的独一真神来的。
The gods that the people of this world worship are not the true God.
很多都是迷信来的。
Many of them are superstition.
什么大树头也是神，什么大石头也是神，什么动物也跑去拜他。
People make rocks, animals, and trees into gods.
什么和尚，什么人。人哦，就是说有很有法术，很有力量，又去信他，去拜他，
people,
去听他，什么都信，什么都给。
People believe and follow religious leaders.
这些我们都是很多人都在信的，这样也这样的也去信他。
People believe in all sorts of things.
既然这些不是神的都跑去信，你们就应该更加信我了。耶稣说，就应该更加相信我了。
If people believe in even such things, how much more should they believe in the Lord Jesus?
因为你可以去看他的一生，他所做的事情。他所行的一些神迹，你可以看，可以检查的。
You can read the life of Jesus. You can examine it closely.
那主耶稣讲一句话。
The Lord Jesus said,
在我父的家里有许多住处。
In my Father's house are many mansions.
是有许多住处啊，你听好啊。
There are many mansions. Let's pay attention.
如果说主耶稣说在父的家里哈有不多的住处，不是很多而已。
If Jesus said in my Father's house there are only a few mansions,
那么我们就很不幸运了。
Then we are really unfortunate.
不是很多住处，人满了我就没有了，满了我就不轮不到我了。
Because once all the mansions are occupied, then I will have no place to stay.
但是主耶稣说
，But the Lord Jesus said,
有许多在天父家里有许多住处啊。
In my Father's house are many mansions.
而且如果没有，我早已经告诉你们。
If it were not so, I would have told you.
耶稣说，如果没有，耶稣会告诉我们说，没有，天上没有我们的家。
If it were not so, Jesus would have told us that there are no mansions in heaven.
耶稣不骗我们。
Our Lord Jesus does not lie.
如果天上没有我们的家，
if there are no mansions in heaven,
我们今天来开布道会做什么啊？
What's the point of attending service here today?
你来听道理到底要听什么呀？
What are you here to listen to?
那我们今天的基督徒，我们信徒参加拜六来聚会啊，来祷告啊，来敬拜干什么呀？
Why do we come every Saturday to worship God and pray to Him?
你敬拜得好，你再虔诚，没有天国啊！
No matter how devout you may be, if there is no heaven,
你再敬拜也没有用啊！
What's the point?
我们讲到天国这么好，天国这么圣洁，天国这么快乐，没有啊！
We may say heaven is so wonderful, heaven is a happy place, but if there is no heaven,
意思说我们所信的，我们所讲的原来是空的一个理论，一个空的东西。
Then our faith and all our talks are empty.
耶稣说如果没有，我会他会告诉我们。
But Jesus said, if it were not so, I would have told you.
我们就不需要这样努力了啦，不需要了，你努力也没有了。
We would not need to waste our effort.
但感谢神，耶稣告诉我们。
But thank God, our Lord Jesus tells us.
在父的家里有许多的住处。
In my Father's house are many mansions.
他说他去就是要为我们预备地方。
He goes to prepare a place for us.
耶稣给我们承诺，我们有永恒的天家。
Our Lord Jesus promises us many mansions in heaven.
我们在马来西亚那边，我们有一个地方正在开拓传福音。
In Malaysia, there is a place where we are building churches.
有一位陈弟兄啊，一位陈弟兄，当时他是还没有信主的。
Preaching the gospel, where there is a brother, Brother Chen. He used to be an unbeliever.
他是很有钱的一个财主。
He was very wealthy.
可是他没有快乐。
But he had not.
那时他躺在医院很久了。
He did not have happiness. He was lying sick in the hospital.
也没有什么人来看他。
Nobody came to visit him.
家人也没有什么来看他。
Even his family hardly visited.
来看他常常都是为了钱财产业在吵架吵闹的。
People who came to visit him would argue over his inheritance.
他那时有钱的时候，健康时候很多酒肉朋友，生病的时候没有几个人。
When he was healthy, he had many fair weather friends. But when he was sick, nobody came.
那我们就到医院去探访病人。
And we went to the church, went to the hospital to visit the sick.
向他传福音，传天国福音。
And we met this gentleman, and we preached to him the gospel.
后来那边的信徒，那边有住一两家信徒，很有爱心，常常去看他。
And two nearby church members were very loving and visited him very often.
有时候还包一些鱼粥啊，一些粥哦，带去给他喝啊，
Sometimes、
给他吃。
They even made a fish porridge and brought it to the hospital.
这个陈先生啊，他开始提防我们了。
And Mr. Chen began to be on guard.
我又不是你的亲人，我又不是你的朋友，我们根本不认识，你为什么对我这么好呀？
He was thinking, I'm not your family, I'm not your friend. Why are you so good to me?
他们开始提防了，又是不是又来想要骗我什么啊？想要讨好我什么呀？
So he tried to distance himself because he was afraid that they came with a motive.
所以他观察了很久，我们教会的弟兄姐妹就是这样很认真的、很诚心的这样来关心他，
but after
也没有跟他讲什么东西。
A period of observation, he noticed that the love of our brothers and sisters are so genuine, they have no motive.
这是一个单纯的主耶稣的爱、主耶稣的关心。
They carry with them the love and concern of the Lord Jesus.
他感受到教会的爱、主耶稣的爱。
He deeply felt the love and the care from our Lord Jesus.
后来接受主耶稣洗礼了。
And he accepted the Lord and was baptized.
我要讲的见证就是他在另一次生病的过程。
What I'd like to share with you is the experience he underwent when he was sick.
那次他也是住医院住很久。
Another time, and he was in the hospital for a long time.
他已经很久没有冲凉、没有洗脸了。
He for a long time he did not take shower or wash his face.
因为他怕冻到水，一冻到水他都就发抖，会冷啊，很冷啊。
Because he could not touch water, as soon as he did that, he would shiver.
所以当然这样也不太卫生啊。
Of course, it wasn't very hygienic.
有一天晚上，他睡的时候就看到一个白衣人穿白衣的，来到他床前跟他盖被单啊。
One night in his sleep, he saw a figure wearing white coming and covering him with a blanket.
那张被单一盖下去哦，就不再冷了。
And once the blanket was covered above him, he did not feel cold anymore.
他一直睡到天亮了。那隔天早上，他去冲凉啊，就是你们说的洗澡啊。
He had such a good sleep, and the next morning he got up and had a shower.
哇，整个洗到干干净净啊。
He was so clean.
那些旁边的病人说，你今天有没有搞错？你今天有怎么发烧了？
The other patients in the same room asked him, is there something wrong with you?
哦，你不怕冷啊？
Aren't you afraid of cold?
他说我不怕啦。
He said, I'm no longer cold.
昨晚有一个穿白衣的人跟我一盖被单，到今天到现在我都不怕冷。
Because last night someone in white came to put a blanket on me, and I no longer felt cold.
后来他们都在找这个地，他有两张被单，这个白衣人给他的是第三张，他一直找那第三张被单都没有了。
And he kept looking for the third blanket, which is the one in white put on him, and he could not find it.
那是第一个晚上，他看到白衣人给他盖被子。
So the first night, he saw the person in white putting on a blanket.
第二个晚上，他梦到哈，他到一个很美丽的花园去。
The second night, he dreamt that he went to a very beautiful garden.
非常的美丽。
It was very, very beautiful.
那个花园有许多非常漂亮的房子。
And in the garden were many beautiful mansions.
他就慢慢的一间一间去欣赏。
And he took his time and visited each mansion.
走到其中一间，他就停下来看。
And he stopped by a particular mansion.
他抬头一看，啊，还有那个屋瓦还没有盖好，其他的都盖好了，还剩下那个屋瓦没有放上去而已。
And he noticed that this A building is still under construction. The tiles of the roof have not been placed on.
他的心想，哎呀，如果这间是我的，那多好呀。
And he was thinking to himself, how wonderful would it be if this was my home?
这是第二个晚上。
This was the second dream.
第三个晚上。
The third night.
他又梦到他自己到那个花园去，很漂亮的花园。
He dreamed again, going back to the same garden, very beautiful garden.
有许多美丽的房子。
He saw many beautiful mansions.
他走呀走，又走到昨天那个房子那边停下来。
He walked around and he stopped at the exact same building.
他抬头一看，哇，那个屋瓦盖好了，整间屋子好了。
And this time he saw that the house was completely built.
那在梦中他自己大大声说，我不要回去了，我要住在这里了。
In the dream he said aloud, I'm not going back, I'm staying here.
突然间有声音告诉他说，你还没有准备好。
Suddenly a voice came to him and said, You're not ready yet.
你准备好了，我就带你回来，我就带你来这里。
When you're ready, I will take you here.
结果他就醒过来了。
And he woke up from his dream.
他就想，我已经受洗了。
He said, I have been baptized.
哦，我又没有离开主，没有离开教会，没有离开道理。
I've never forsaken the Lord or his word.
我还准备什么呢？
How can I be more
ready? 哎呀，我知道了，我还没有圣灵啊。
And he realized that he still had not received the Holy Spirit.
Oh, 原来他还没有准备好，就还没有准备好圣灵，还没有得到圣灵。
He was not ready because he had not received the Holy Spirit.
他就马上在病床上，在床上一直祷告求圣灵。
So right on his hospital bed, he knelt down and prayed for the Holy Spirit.
他自己见证，也不知道祷告了多久，也不知道祷告了多少次。
according to his testimony, he prayed again and again for a long time.
他累了就休息，休息了又在祷告，祷告累了又休息，休息了又在祷告，这样重复不断的重复。
He would take breaks every now and then, but he would continue praying unceasingly.
他迫切的求圣灵，他要回家了。
He prayed earnestly for the Holy Spirit because he wants to go home.
在这个世界干什么？
Heaven is so beautiful. There's no point living in this world.
有了钱又看又怎么样啊？
So what if you have a lot of money?
没有钱也痛苦，有钱也很痛苦。
People who are wealthy are just as painful as those who don't have money.
没钱也是为钱吵吵闹闹，有钱也是为产业钱财吵吵闹闹。
People
在干什么呀？
Who are poor fight, and people who are wealthy also fight.
这种人生有什么快乐？有什么价值？
There's no joy in this kind of life.
他认识了主耶稣。
Now he has come to know the Lord Jesus.
他明白了神的爱。
He knows the love of God now.
他更拥有了天国的盼望，那个永恒的家，那个盼望。
And he has the hope of the everlasting home in heaven.
可是他没圣灵啊。
But he still has not received the Holy Spirit. And the voice told him, when you're ready, I will take you home.
结果他跟医生申请要出来啊，要去教会祷告啊。
So he told the hospital and asked to be discharged because he wanted to go to church to pray. But the doctor would not agree.
结果他叫他的孩子跟医生讲，叫他孩子来跟医生讲，叫他申请出去。
He told the children to come to the hospital and ask the doctor to give him permission to leave.
那天安息日哦，他医生就批准他，让他来敬拜神。
The following Sabbath day, the doctor gave him the permission to come to church to worship God.
他孩子就坐用轮椅推着他进来。
His children wheeled him into the chapel.
他孩子把他推到后面旁边，他说不要，我要到前面。你一定要不，他一定要到前面来。
They wheeled him to the back corner, but he insisted that they wheeled him all the way to the front of the chapel.
他等传道讲到人还没有结束啊，传道口水太多了，还没有结束，他要跪下来祷告了，他不要等传道了。
Even before the sermon,
他要跪下来祷告了。
Even before the sermon was finished, he was so eager to kneel down to pray.
他意思说等这么久，讲这么久还没有结束。
He was thinking how come the sermon is so long because he was waiting to pray.
结果那些信徒一直叫他慢点，慢点。
But the members in church told him to slow down.
那种迫切的心啊，要祷告求圣灵的心，很迫切。
Because he was filled with such earnesty.
结果讲到结束就祷告嘛。
And after the sermon, we were about to pray.
他第一个大大声喊，奉主耶稣圣名祷告，主耶稣给我圣灵啊！主耶稣一直在喊啊。
He was the first to cry aloud, "In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord Jesus, give me the Holy Spirit."
一个老人，一个病人，这么迫切祷告求圣灵，他在听到都很感动。
He was an old man, and he was praying for the Holy Spirit like this, and everyone was very touched.
很多弟兄姐妹也替他祷告，为他祷告，主啊，给他圣灵啊！
Brothers and sisters prayed for him and asked the Lord Jesus to give him the Holy Spirit.
耶稣真的就在那次给他了。
And during that very prayer, the Lord Jesus gave him the Holy Spirit.
一直高兴，一直在笑。
He was so filled with joy.
这个我要回家了，我可以回家了。
And he was filled with laughter, and he said, "Now I can go home."
很多人不知道他见证的，不知道他在讲什么。什么叫做回家？他以为他要回他的住家。
Many people didn't understand what he was saying because they thought that he meant he wanted to go back to his home.
他要回家是指天上的家。
But he actually meant the heavenly home that he saw in his dream.
过不久，耶稣真的带他回去了。
And surely thereafter, the Lord took him home.
感谢主，这是我们的见证啊，教会的见证。
Thank God, this is a true testimony in our church.
耶稣应许说，在父的家里有许多住处。
The Lord Jesus promised, "In my Father's house there are many mansions."
这是真实的。
And this is true.
另外一个叫做黄永泰弟兄，黄弟兄。
We have another brother, brother 黄永泰。
那时他也是还是外邦人，不是信主的。
He used to be an unbeliever.
一样也是个财主，很多很有钱的。
He was also very wealthy.
后来因为他的产业被股东吞噬掉了，被骗了，结果变成破产了。
But because a fraud, all his money was cheated and taken away.
然后家人也因为这样不能够原谅他，也不理他了。
Because he lost all his money, his family would not forgive him.
他感受到人生的无情啊，这种亲情的这种经不起考验的亲情。
And he realized how fragile love in this world is.
结果他灰心的，曾经去自杀两次到三次。
Because he was so distraught, he was so discouraged, he tried to kill himself a few times.
用刀割他的脉的时候，开始割了。结果他想到如果我死了，我去哪里啊？
One time he was about to cut his artery, and Suddenly, a thought stopped him. Where would I go if I die?
对那些拜拜的人，不认识耶稣的人哦，拜拜的人都是说下地狱的嘛，都是阎罗王那边嘛，都是这样讲的呀。
Because those who worship idols, they believe that when they die, they will go down to hell.
我就这样死掉，这样就下阎罗王下地狱这样，那我才不要哦。
And he thought, if I die like this, I'm going to go to hell. I don't want that.
我又没有做什么恶事啊。
I haven't done anything evil.
我的钱是被人家骗的。
People trick me of my money.
我不是去骗人家啊。
I never tricked anyone.
我现在是被家人遗弃啊，不是我丢掉我的家，我是被家人丢啊。
I was forsaken by my
family. 然后要我下地狱，我才不要呢。
I'm forsaken by my family. I never forsook them, but now I have to go to hell.
可是不然你叫他们去哪里呀？
But where would these? Where else could you go?
他们拜拜的都没有天国的嘛，没有天国的，拜拜的人不讲天国的，也根本不信天国的，
because
就是下去的。
Idol worshippers do not believe in heaven. The only direction they can go is down.
不是这样子吗？
Isn't that so?
结果他又不敢死啊。So
he was afraid to cut himself.
活他又不愿意活，死又不敢死，所以他很痛苦啊。He
did not want to live, but he dared not die, so he was in such pain.
他的见证蛮长的啦。He
has a very long testimony.
后来，他另一次要决定要死了啦，反正不管了，我不活了，我不想活了。And
then later on, another time, he was so determined to kill himself.
那时他认识到外教会了，他有去过外教会了。By
that time, he had attended other churches.
然后他感受不到，还是感受不到神的爱，感受不到。
He still could not feel God's love.
他就跟主耶稣说。So
he told the Lord Jesus.
主啊，哪一间才是你真正的教会？
Lord, which church is your true church?
哪一间才是我的家？我去到，我感受到好像是我的家。Which
church can I go and really feel that this is my home?
他去了好几间，很多外教会，他没有感受到回家的感觉。He
visited many Christian churches, but could never feel that he was at home.
他说：“主耶稣啊，我给你最后的机会了。”他这样祷告，他给耶稣机会哦，不是耶稣给他机会。He
told the Lord Jesus, "Lord, I'm giving you one more chance." Instead of asking Jesus for another chance, he gave Jesus one more chance.
我就结束了，我也不想活了。He
said, "Unless you show me, I don't want to live anymore."
求你带领我。Please
guide me.
我现在祷告过后呢，15分钟里面呢，要有一辆车停在我家的面前。After
I finish praying, within 15 minutes, you're gonna make a car come and stop at my house.
而且这辆车一定是要教会的车，一定要教会的车。And
this car must be a church vehicle.
然后呢，教会的车，这辆车呢，要载我自动的，说要载我去教会。And
this driver of this vehicle must take the initiative to ask me to go to church with him.
然后他说，主，我只给你15分钟而已。So
he said, "Jesus, I'm only giving you 15 minutes."
还有这样祷告的哦。There
are people who pray like that.
车要停在你面前，那是容易啦。The
car must stop in front of my house.
但是要教会的车停在你面前就不容易啦。But
it's not that simple for a church car to stop in front of your house.
停过后又要主动的说要带你去教会，更加不容易啦，因为不认识嘛。And
the driver of the car has to come down and invite you to church because he doesn't even know you.
然后他说他不要等太久的，只给15分钟哦。 如果超过15分钟就不是了。He
only gives Jesus 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, it doesn't count.
然后他起来看。 一直看有没有车停。
After prayer, he got up. He kept looking around to see if there's a car.
有很多车走来走去，没有一辆车停。Many
cars came up and passed.
差不多就要到十五分钟了。It
was almost at the 15-minute mark.
就有一辆van车停在他们面前。Then
suddenly, a van stopped in front of the house.
哇，他赶快出去看什么车来的。He
rushed out to look at the what kind of car it was.
真耶稣教会。On
the van, it said, "True Jesus Church."
那个是耶稣的车啊。Oh,
that's Jesus' car.
那么他开门出来，and
he opened the door.
我们的传道就问他，哎呀，先生啊，我在这里找一个信徒，我迷路了，请问你那个路是怎样走啊？And
the preacher got off the car and asked him, "Gentlemen, I lost my way. I'm looking for a church member, but I can't find the house. Can you please direct me?"
这个黄先生他说我不知道了。
And Mr. Huang said, "I don't know."
那么我们的传道突然间，那我载不到他了。那你要不要去教会啊？我载你去了。So
the
反正我载不到那个信徒，我找不到他了。The
preacher said, "Well, if I cannot find this member, why don't you come with me to church?" And he said, "You are taking me to church."
是啊，你要不要去？我载你去啊。Yes,
I'm taking you to church. Do you want to come with me?
这就是他祷告的情形啊，他祷告向耶稣要的啊。
This was exactly what he asked from Jesus.
其实我们传道是找信徒。 迷路了。
But our preacher was looking for a church member and got lost.
因为那个信徒是从外地来的，来这里做工的，很久没有去教会传道去找他。
He was looking for a member who came from out of town who hasn't been to church for a long time.
有时神就会带领我们的脚步，在生活上这样的脚步。
So God can guide our footsteps in so many different ways in life.
他一进到教会。
And when he stepped into the church,
他是一个五十多六十岁的老人呐、啊，大的成人呐、啊。
He was in his 50s or 60s, someone.
他进到教会哦，好像小孩子这样哦，一直哭啊，一直哭，好像小孩子啊，看到离开几十年没有见到的父亲这样，一直哭啊。
But when he stepped into the church, he cried and cried like a baby.
我们其他接待的人都吓到了，以为他发生什么事呀。
And the rest of the people at church were so shocked that he acted like this.
后来他见证说，他感受到有一双手用慈祥的手抱着他。
Because he felt loving arms embracing him.
好像浪子哈，已经离开家太久，回家了，我回家了。
Like a prodigal son who has been away from home for so long.
这种是骗不到的，这种是做。想要假假不到的。
This is not something you can fabricate.
这种是很真诚的在哭，在感动。
He was so touched that he was weeping like a baby.
好，那后来他好，我们讲到最后他离世的情形。
And eventually, fast forward to the time when he was about to leave this world.
主耶稣带他回去。
The Lord Jesus was about to take him
home. 主耶稣是派跑，只有他是骑着白马上天城啊。
He rode on a white horse to go back to the castle in heaven.
我们在开这个慰言聚会，在办这种丧礼聚会。
During the middle of the funeral service,
他的女儿、他的太太、他的儿子，还有他的兄弟姐妹，这个网友，他这个死者的兄弟姐妹。
His wife, his children, and his siblings.
十几个人来参加。
About a dozen of them came to attend.
那他的女儿哦，有点难过吧，就跑到外面去散散心。
His daughter felt quite sad, and she stepped out
for a moment.
And she looked up at the sky.
她看到她的爸爸哦，全身穿着发光的白衣啊，很年轻啊，一直向她挥手，一直向她挥手。
She saw her father looking so young, wearing white, waving at her.
爸爸非常的好看，非常的年轻。
Her father was very good looking and very young.
穿着白衣，发光的白衣。
Wearing white, shining.
她以为她心理作用
，She thought she was seeing things，
或者一种眼看错了，一种眼花的问题。
That it was illusion。
她就往地下看。
So she looked down on the ground。
然后再往上面看。
And then looked up again。
爸爸还是一直向她挥手。
She saw her father again waving at her。
她知道这个是真的，不是心理作用。
That she realized that it was real。
她就赶快跑到聚会的地方，叫她的爸妈妈出去看。
She rushed back to the service and told his mother， 她说她看到爸爸 her mother to go out to see。
她说她看到爸爸了。
She said she saw
爸爸非常的年轻啊。
She saw daddy and how daddy looked so young.
你不要乱讲。
The mother said, don't make things up.
也许孩子因为太伤心了，错觉了。
She thought that her daughter was so sad that she was seeing things.
你出来看，你赶快出来看。
But she insisted, mom, come out and look.
结果他们十几个人哦，噼里啪啦噼啦这样跑出去。
So the entire family rushed out of the building.
也影响了我们的正道暂停啊，因为不知道发生什么事呀。
And we had to stop the service because we didn't know what was going on.
结果他们十几个人出去看的时候，看到他的爸爸骑着白马进入天城里面，天上有一个很美丽的城，进入里面。
So more than 10 of them went out, and they all saw the father riding into the city in heaven.
看到父亲的背影，还有那只马的尾巴。
They saw the back of their father as well as the tail of the horse.
非常的美丽，那个发着光，那云彩都发着光的进入城里面，那个整个城都是金光闪闪发光的城。
It was very beautiful, and the city was full of light.
这是我们在丧礼聚会的时候一个很真实的见证。
This is something real that happened during that particular funeral service.
也许你说这是你们自己讲的。
You may tell me, well, you made it up.
朋友，这不是我们讲的呢。
Friends, we did not make it up.
这些见证是那十几个不信耶稣的人讲的呢。
These testimonies were shared by those unbelieving family members.
我再讲清楚，这十几个看到他的亲人骑白马进天宫，看着还是不信耶稣，到今天还不信耶稣。
More than 10 of them, they were unbelievers when they saw the vision. Even today, they still don't believe in Jesus.
那些不信的人讲这个见证是他们讲的，不是我们在讲的，他们见证的。
They were the ones who told us about this testimony. We did not make it up.
真的有天国。
heaven is real.
耶稣说, 如果没有,
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, if it were not so, I would have told you.
但是很可惜了,
Very unfortunate.
亲眼看到这样, 也还不相信, 那没话讲,
even though they saw this vision, they still did not believe.
我们不是说要看到这些才相信, 不是。
We don't have to see visions before we believe.
我们没有看到异象, 没有这种见证, 我们早已经相信有天国了。
Even without seeing visions, we believe that heaven is real.
因为主耶稣讲,
because Jesus has told us.
信耶稣, 你就要信耶稣讲的话。
If you believe in the Lord Jesus, you must believe in his word.
你信耶稣, 又不信耶稣讲的话, 那你到底在信什么呀?
If you say you believe in Jesus, but don't trust in his word, then you're not a true believer.
亲爱的朋友,
Dear friends,
其实你留意看哦, 你留意去听哦, 很多信耶稣的人说, 我信耶稣, 他不信耶稣讲的话的, 他不信的。
If you pay close attention to those professed Christians, many of them don't believe in Jesus' words.
我们信耶稣, 信耶稣讲的话。
We believe in Jesus, we must believe in his word.
这才是真正的信主。
That is true faith.
主说, 在父的家里有许多住处, 耶稣这样讲, 我们就这样相信。
Our Lord said, in my Father's house are many mansions. He has said it, and we must believe.
而且耶稣再加上说, 如果没有, 我会告诉你们,
He even added, if it were not so, I would have told you. We trust that he is trustworthy.
主耶稣给我们永恒的应许。
Jesus has given us eternal promises.
他给我们什么应许呢?
What promises has
我想,
he given us?
我讲最后一个了。
I'd like to share with you one more.
那 请看《约翰福音书》14章。
Please read John chapter 14.
我们读第三节。
Verse 3.
请念。
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
主耶稣说，他去是为我们预备地方去。
Jesus goes and prepare a place for us.
然后他承诺说，哈 ，promise 我们说，他哈会再来，他再来。 要再来接我们到他那边去。
He promises that he will come again to receive us.
叫他在哪里, 他要叫我们也跟他在哪里。
That where he is, there we may be also.
这是主耶稣给我们的第三个承诺。
This is the third promise of our Lord Jesus.
他还要再来接我们回去。
He is coming again to receive us.
我们那边也有很多这种悲伤的事情。
Where I'm from, there are many such moments of sorrow.
做孩子的, 把年老的父母, 再到城市去, 把他们丢在那边。
There are incidents where children take their elderly parents to the city and dump them there.
然后叫年老的父母说, 你们不要乱走啊, 你们在这里等我啊, 不要走啊, 我会, 我会来载你们啊。
These young people tell their elderly parents, wait for me here, I'm coming back to get you.
他的两个老人家等呀等等等等等到月亮出来, 还没有孩子还没有来。
The elderly couple wait in the city even until the moon comes up and their children don't show up.
等到星星都出来了, 也还没来。
Even when the stars come up in the sky, they don't see their children.
他孩子骗他啦。
Their children tricked them.
把老人家丢在那边不理他了，说我要倒回来，你不要走啊，我倒回来啊，骗他，哪有回来？
They dumped their parents in the middle of a city, and they could not go home.
老人家又有一点痴呆哦，都不知道自己住哪里，也不知道什么名字，也没有，也不知道电话。
Some of these senior citizens are senile, so they don't know their phone numbers or how to get home.
不知道这里有没有这样的事情。
I don't know if such things happen around here.
有一些把孩子遗弃也是这样，你不要乱跑啊，你在这里等我啊，走了，孩子在那边吱吱的等。
Some parents also abandon their children in the same way.
今天我们，主耶稣也向我们承诺。
Today, our Lord Jesus promises us.
叫我们在世上等他。
He tells us to wait for him.
他还会再来接我们。
That he will come and receive us.
这是他对我们的承诺，他再要来接我们上去。
This is his promise to us that he will come and receive us.
当耶稣再来的时候，叫做第二次再来，知道吗？
When the Lord Jesus comes again, it is called the second coming.
原来他曾经来过这个世界一次。
Because he has come once in this world.
那时他是来拯救我们，自己钉死十字架，牺牲他的生命，流出他的宝血来救赎我们，那是第一次来。
He came the first time to lay down his life and shed his blood to save us.
后来他 复活升天啊,
Later, he was risen and he went back
他承诺,
to heaven.
他还会再来到这个世界,
but he promised that he will come a second time.
不过那第二次来就不是在拯救我,
but the second time is not for salvation. The second time, he will judge the world.
那就是审判那些作恶的, 那些不信的,
he will judge the evildoers and the unbelievers.
主耶稣要做一个, 很可怕的审判。
that would be a terrifying judgment.
但是对我们信主的人来说，那个不是审判。
But for us believers, it is not a judgment to be afraid of.
那是主耶稣来带我们回去。
Rather, we will be received by our Lord Jesus.
也是主耶稣承诺的，他来带我们回去，不是来审判我们，是来带我们回去。
Jesus promised that he will come and receive us to himself.
所以在保罗的书信也说，我们将来要与主在空中相遇啊，我们被提上天，跟主在空中相遇。
So in Paul's letters, we are told that we will meet with the Lord Jesus.
可是对这个世界的人来讲，那是个可怕的审判。
But to the people of this world, that will be a horrible judgment.
但那些不信的人，那些作恶的人，是个可怕、很可怕的审判。
Those who do evil and those who do not believe in the Lord, that will be a terrifying day.
那当主耶稣来的时候是怎么样的情形呢？
What will it be like when the Lord Jesus comes?
我们看这个彼得后书第三章。
Let's turn to 2 Peter chapter 3.
彼得后书第三章。
2 Peter chapter 3.
先读第八节。
Verse 8.
读一节。
But beloved, do not forget this one thing, that with the Lord, one day is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day.
你亲爱的朋友，你读明白这段圣经吗？
Do you understand this verse?
这段圣经很矛盾的。
This is a contradictory verse.
到底主耶稣在讲什么东西呀？
What is Jesus saying?
这里说他看主耶稣看一天看一日，哎呦，好像千年。
With the Lord, one day is as 1,000 years.
那突然就想看一千年，哎呀，好像一日罢了吗？
And immediately he says, 1,000 years is one day.
到底耶稣在讲什么呀？
What is he saying?
这根本是两个极端嘛，两个很冲突的事情啊。
This is a clear contradiction.
你当然不明白了。
Of course you don't understand.
因为你不明白十字架的道理。
Because you don't know the message of the cross.
昨天我们就在解释这个公义跟慈爱。
Yesterday we explained about mercy
and justice. 对神的公义来讲，那个公义来讲，圣洁的公义来讲。
As far as God's holy justice is concerned.
有罪的他一定要审判。
He must condemn the sinful.
他不能够容许一些罪恶、一些污秽在他的眼前呐。
God cannot tolerate the smallest sin.
他不能够看到有凶杀啊，有这种不道德的事情啊，这种淫乱的事情，他不能忍受。
He does not tolerate murder or sexual immorality.
因为公义就是很圣洁的。
Because God is just, He is holy.
虽然只是一天而已啊。
Even though it may be one day.
在神的感受来讲，哎呦。好像过一千年，这个一日度日如年呐、啊，它是度日如千年呐、啊。
For God, it is as long as 1,000 years.
因为都是罪恶，都是凶杀，他很难过。
Because he sees that the world is filled with murder.
在短短的一天，主耶稣看为很长很长很长，很难过，很难过，很难过。
So one day to the Lord may feel like 1,000 years.
那是主耶稣的公义。
That is with respect to his justice.
但是用主耶稣的慈爱来讲。
But from the perspective of his mercy,
慈爱就是要救赎人嘛。
His mercy means he wants to save us.
他看一千年哦，哎呀，才一天罢了，再给他机会啦。
So 1,000 years may seem like one day because he wants to save.
虽然他们现在还在软弱，虽然他们还在犯罪
，and give us another chance.
忍耐一下啦。
Even though people continue to sin,
你看才一千年，才一天罢了，一千年，主耶稣说：“吼，一千年罢了，好像一天啊。”他说：“只有一天罢了。”
He's very forbearing, even though it's been 1,000 years. He says it's only be one day.
再给他第二天啦。
Give him another day.
第二天就是两千年了。
Which is 2,000 years.
哎呀，才两天，给他三天啦，再三千年啦。
Only 2 days. Give him another day, which is 1,000 years.
其实这节在说明吼，主耶稣的心很揪心的。
So this verse explains how contradictory Jesus' heart is.
一方面是公义的，一方面是要慈爱救赎的。
He is just and loving.
所以他就有了这两种对日子哦，对一天的不同的看法，不同的感受。
So it talks about the two different contrasting feelings of God concerning
time. 我今天这样跟你解释，就是要让你明白神的心呐、啊，主耶稣的那颗心呐、啊。
So what I'm trying to explain to you is the heart of God.
在罪恶里面，他不能忍受，一天都不能忍受，好像一千年这样。
God cannot tolerate even one day of sin because it's like 1,000 years to him.
在他的大慈爱、大爱当中，
but in His great love.
他就看一千年好像一天这样不断的忍耐你，不断的宽容你。
A thousand years is like a day. He keeps giving us another chance.
所以请你读第九节。
Verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning His promise, as some count slackness, but is long-suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
你看,主耶稣要来,
the Lord Jesus said that He was coming soon, but even today, He's still not here.
很多人就笑我们了,
so some people laugh at us.
耶稣哪里有来?
Where is Jesus coming? He's not coming.
那有一些信徒也开始怀疑了，这样的信心也开始摇动了。
Some believers' faith is even shaken.
但是圣经告诉我们，
But the Bible teaches us.
主耶稣不是单言。
The Lord is not slacking. It's not slack.
其实他宽容我们，在忍耐我们。
But He is forbearing toward us.
因为他不愿意有一个人沉沦了。
Not willing that any should perish.
这就是神的心。
This is the heart of God.
神有一个心愿。
God has this desire. What is God's desire? His desire
is to see everyone be saved. Everyone
His wish is that everyone should repent and be saved. This is the heart of God, the wish of God.
你也有你的心愿，我也有我的心愿。
You may have some wish, I may have mine.
但是你明白神的心愿吗？
Do you know God's wish?
原来神的心就是要每个人得救，这个就是神的心愿。
God's wish is for everyone to be saved.
可是世人不明白神的心愿。
But the people of the world do not know God's heart. They make fun of God and mock Him. Some even slander God. We really break God's heart. And verse 10 tells us about the day of the Lord. The day of the Lord will come as a thief.
然后呢，那一日来的时候，必有大响声、大爆炸的声音。
The heavens will pass away with a great noise.
然后地上和其上的物，所有的物质都被烈火融化掉，被火融掉。
And the elements will melt with fervent heat.
好，为什么圣经常常说主耶稣来的时候好像贼来这样？为什么这样讲？
Why does the Bible often compare the day of the Lord as a thief?
老师说，贼来是不好的，对不对？
For the thief to come to your house is not a good thing.
那为什么常常说耶稣来好像贼这样呢？要用这样来比喻呢？为什么？开始我都不明白啊。
But at first I trouble understanding why does the Bible use thief to compare Jesus coming?
后来我们明白了。
And later I understood.
好，有几点要注意，贼来的时候你注意。Pay
attention to the day of the thief.
贼来偷东西、来抢东西，都是在夜深、夜黑、夜深的时候，就是他触动的时候，就是他来的时候。
The thief would come in the darkest of night.
虽然说是今天大白天还是有贼啦。 但是普遍上，黑夜就是他们作案的时间，黑夜就是他们出现的时间。
Even though some people steal during the day, but the thief usually act at night.
是吗？所以你黑夜来到的时候，你的门锁啊，这个锁那边锁，这里锁，对不对？
That's why.
你白天你这样到处锁的吗？白天你没有这样锁的啦。
That's why we lock our windows and our doors at night.
你在防什么啊？这里锁那边锁，就防贼嘛。
Why are you afraid? Because you don't want thieves to come in.
就是很夜的时候，很黑的时候，贼就到了。
The thief would come at the darkest moment of the night.
今天世界越来越黑暗了，就是主耶稣要来的时候了。
Today the world is getting darker and darker, and that's when Jesus will come.
第二，为什么？ 说好像贼这样。
Second, why is it compared to the thief?
贼来的时候，他不会告诉你的。
First, the thief will not tell you that he's coming.
他会被打一通电话，你等下1:30或者2:00我到了。
Will the thief ever call you and say, "I'm coming at 1:30 or 2"?
贼来，他不告诉你。
He will never come tell you.
在这个黑暗这一段时间当中，他随时到的，他不会通知你。
During this moment of darkness, he may come anytime. He will not give you any warning.
主耶稣也是一样，他来的时候，他不会再通知你的。
In the same way, when the Lord Jesus comes, He will not give you any warning. He will just come.
那时候人又吃又喝又买又卖又盖房子又拆房子。
As Jesus said, people will be eating and drinking and building houses.
突然间人子就到，突然间就进来了。
And suddenly the Son of Man will come.
因为他不告诉你了。
He will not give you any notice.
第三点。
Third.
什么叫做贼来呢？
What does it mean to be like a thief?
我请问你，贼进你的家的时候呢，他会偷你什么东西？
When the thief comes into your house, what will he steal?
哇，这朵花很美哦！哎呀，我拿回，我偷回去了。This
flower is so beautiful. I'm gonna steal this flower.
哎呀，这个很特别啊！哎，我偷这个回去了，会吗？
This is so special. Let me take this home.
这个贼哪里要偷这种东西呀？Thieves
don't want those things.
贼进我们的家，他要偷的就是你最贵重的、最宝贵的，就是他要偷的。
or the thing that your possession that's most valuable to you is what the thief wants.
在我们人生里面，我们这个世界，我们的生活里面，请问最贵重的是什么？
In your life, what is the most important, most valuable?
不知道啊，我知啊。最贵重的就是我们的珠宝啦。
Needless to say, your jewelry.
钻石啊。
Your diamonds.
金条啊。
Your gold bars.
这是我们最贵重的了。
These are your most valuable things.
贼来，他一定偷家里。你最贵重的他就拿。
The thief will come and take the most valuable possessions you have.
他绝对不会去偷你的一个滴数啦，一个钟啦，他不会偷这种，这种他不要。
He will not take away accessories. He's not interested in those.
主耶稣来的时候，要拿走我们的是什么？最贵重的你认为是什么？
When the Lord Jesus comes, what is the most valuable thing that he will take from you?
当然不是这些珠宝啦。
Of course, it's not these jewelries.
这个珠宝在神的眼里，这根本都是石头来的，没什么价值的。
Jewelries are worthless in God's eyes.
在神眼里最贵重的就是我们的灵魂生命。
In the eyes of God, your most valuable possession is your life and your soul.
这是主耶稣要的。
This is what Jesus
wants. 他来就把你最贵重的灵魂生命拿走了。
When he comes, he will take away your most valuable, which is your life and your soul.
所以主耶稣说，赚得全世界有什么用？赔上生命。
Jesus said, what is the good of earning the whole world if forfeiting your life?
因为生命在神眼里头比全世界更贵重，生命才贵重。
In God's eyes, life is more valuable than anything.
耶稣要的哈，要来要拿的就是灵魂生命。
The Lord Jesus come to receive your life.
那就是永远的。
And that is eternal.
你享乐享福也是永远，你受苦受审判也是永远的。他要拿的是这个东西、啊。
Whether it is bliss or woe, it will be an eternal outcome.
所以你现在明白了，以后你再看到吼主来的日子好像贼这样，你就要明白他在讲什么， so, 他在警告我们什么。
So the next time when you read about the day of the Lord, then you understand what he's talking about.
耶稣要拿的是要拿收取的是灵魂生命，最宝贵。
Because the Lord Jesus will come to receive our life, which is the most
valuable. 那跟着呢，这世界被烈火焚烧了。
And then the world will be melt, will melt with fire.
哦，那这是一个超预言、超时代的预言。
And this is a transcendent prophecy.
你看第十节。
Verse 10.
那日天必大有响声废去。
The heavens will pass away with a great noise.
有形质的都要被烈火消化、融化。
The elements will melt with fervent heat.
这是一个预言，将来世界末日的克制战争、克制爆炸。
This is a prophecy of the nuclear explosion.
有大响声在爆炸，在爆炸。
Because there is a great noise.
有大火烧起来。
And great fires will burn.
这个就是克制战争的情形来的。
This is a scene of a nuclear destruction.
好，很科学的一个常识，很科学的常识。
And this is a scientific common sense.
水哦，到一百度哦，水到一百度，热度一百的时候就会开始滚了，是不是
？When water reaches 100 degrees, it starts to boil.
钢铁它热到一千度的时候，钢铁就开始融了。
When steel reaches 1,000 degrees, it melts.
你听好哦，一千度钢铁开始融了。
At 1,000 degrees, even metals melt.
当初第二次世界大战的时候，美国。放的那个原子弹在日本广岛的那个原子弹的热度原子弹的热度是6000度。
During the Second World War, the U.S. dropped atomic bombs in Japan, and that the heat of that bomb was 6000.
将来的克制世界末日的战争，第三次世界大战的战争是克制弹，克制弹的热度是18000度啊！我的天呐、啊！
The heat of the nuclear weapon, which will be dropped during the Third War, is 18,000 degrees.
一千度钢铁都已经融了。
If even 1,000 degrees can melt steel,
一万八千度的热度还有什么可以存留的？可以存在这个世界、啊、
？What can survive under the heat of 18,000 degrees?
这是很科学的、很实在的一个常识啊。
This is a common sense.
所以圣经说。有形质的这个世界，这种物质全部都要被烈火、这种热度、这种火融化掉、烧毁掉、啊。
That's why the Bible tells us that all the elements will melt with fervent heat.
那是人要躲去哪里啊？哪里可以躲啊？
At that time, where can we escape?
真的是世界末日的、啊。
That will be the last day.
耶稣说了，他要再来。
The Lord Jesus said that He is coming.
他讲的话一定会实现，他不骗我们。
His words will surely come true.
不过他来呢，是带我们回去，不是来审判我们。
For us, He will come to receive us, not to judge us.
这就是我们今天为什么要信耶稣。
That's why we must believe in the Lord Jesus today.
为什么要遵守神的道理。
That's the reason why we keep God's word today.
那最后我们来讲一个，主耶稣的应许是什么呢？
Finally, what is the promise of the Lord?
我们来看看应许是什么。
What is our Lord's promise?
请看这个约翰一书第二章。
Let's read 1 John chapter 2.
约翰一书第二章。
1 John chapter 2.
我们读25节。
Verse 25.
请念25节。
Verse 25. Yeah. And this is the promise that He has promised us, eternal life.
这里说，主耶稣应许给我们的就是永生。
The promise of our Lord Jesus is eternal life.
永生就是永远不死。
That means to not die ever.
主耶稣给我们最大的应许就是永生，永远不死，永远生存。
The greatest promise of our Lord Jesus is to live eternally.
而且那种永生是快乐的，是平安的，是圣洁的。
And it's eternal happiness and eternal holiness and joy.
我们教会有位老姐妹去世的时候。
You know, there's an elderly sister when she was about to pass away. Many church members gathered around her bed to pray for her.
这个信徒从年轻，从做少女时代，到她结婚，到她年老，都是这样的爱主耶稣，爱教会。
This elderly sister, from her youth to her, through her married life, she had loved the Lord very much.
那种爱神的心没有改变过，从少女到老人。
From her youth till her old age, she never changed her love for the Lord or for the church.
所以大家都很感动，被她这种信仰、这种爱神的心、这种真实的信仰感动了。
So all the church members were very touched by her love.
那大家在替她祷告的时候呢，就看她被主耶稣接回去。And
during their prayer, they all saw her being taken away by the Lord Jesus.
看她这个老人家突然在灵里，在异象中是非常年轻漂亮的，也是穿白衣的。In
the vision, they saw her as a very beautiful young lady wearing white.
天国没有老人的，知道吗？
There are no elderly people.
虽然你已经老老了，没有牙齿了，这样了，可是，在天国很漂亮。
You may be old now, you've lost all your teeth, but in heaven you'll be beautiful and young.
我有老人就不美了，人家老人就只要我腰痛呢，等下就我不能走路要拿桶杆呢，没有这样的事了。
There are no elderly or disabled in the heaven.
有一些人已经断一条腿的，有一些人瞎一只眼睛的，那天国怎么快乐啊？
Some people,
天国没有这些人，全部都恢复成漂亮、年轻、健康、健壮的。In
heaven, everyone is healthy and whole.
那看到这个老姐妹呢？她这个改变的那种美丽的形象，抓住一个十字架，很大的白色十字架，抓住十字架，一直往天上升呐。
And they saw this elderly sister, who was looked very young and beautiful, holding onto a cross and rose up to heaven.
要到半空的时候呢？ 这个姐妹就回头对那些正祷告的人讲了两句话。And
when she reached mid-air, she turned around and said to those who were praying for her.
讲什么呢？
What did she say?
她说，要抓住神的应许。She
said, hold on to God's promises.
神的应许是什么？
What are the promises of God?
刚才我们看圣经了，这里说神的应许就是永生。Just
now we've read that God's promise is eternal life.
那为什么她抓住十字架往上升呢？
Why did she hold on to the cross?
到底这个要表达什么？要解释什么
？What was it telling them?
十字架原来就是神的救恩啊，神的救赎啊。The
cross is God's salvation and redemption.
抓住神的救恩，不要放弃，抓住神的救恩，上天国。We
must take hold of the salvation of God and go to heaven.
不要放弃，抓稳稳。We
must not let go. We must hold firmly.
真的应许就是永生。God's
promise is eternal life.
坚持到底。
We must hold firmly to the end.
那第二句话，她回头对那些祷告人讲的第二句话。And
the second thing she said to those who were praying for her.
什么话呢？
Was this.
神不会离去人。
God never forsakes man.
只有人会离去神。
Only man forsakes God.
这是真的。
This is true.
亲爱的朋友。
Dear friends.
包括兄弟姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
神不会离去人。
God does not forsake man.
只有人会离去神。
But man forsakes God.
当你说神离去你的时候，其实是你已经先离开神了。
When you say that God has forsaken you, actually you have forsaken God first.
你先不听他的话，你先不遵守他的话了，你先不遵守他的真理了。
Because you refuse to hear His word and follow His gospel.
就好像教会也不会离开你啊。
In the same way, the church will not forsake you. You are the one who leave the church. The church will never leave you. So let's take her words to heart. First, hold on to God's promise. You already have this promise. Second, God does not forsake man, man forsakes God.
我们看一节圣经来结束。
Let's conclude with the verse.
我很喜欢这节圣经。
This is my favorite verse.
希望你也会喜欢。
And I hope that it can be your favorite.
提摩太后书二章。
Please turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2.
为什么要看这章圣经呢？
Why do we look at this passage?
你自己看着就明白。
Once you read it, you will know.
提摩太后书二章。
2 Timothy chapter 2.
我们读13节。
Verse 13.
请念。
If we are faithless, he remains faithful. He cannot deny himself.
Hallelujah, 感谢主耶稣。
Hallelujah, thank the Lord Jesus.
我们从然是信。
Even if we are faithless,
他仍然是可以相信的。
He remains faithful.
为什么？
Why?
因为他不能够背负自己啊。
Because he cannot deny himself.
他是神啊。
He is God.
他不能够讲了的话，做过的承诺，他说，哎呦，我忘记了。 我有这样讲咩？ 啊， 对不起啊， 我忘了啊。
He cannot say something.
你开玩笑啊你啊。
And later say, oh, I forgot what I said, or did I really say it?
他自己讲过的话， 他承诺过的， 他不能背负自己的， 他不能够说讲话不算数的。
Whatever he promises, he cannot deny himself and eat his word.
如果他也是这样， 那他还是神啊。 那我们还要信他吗？
Goes back on his word, how can he be God?
那他说讲了一句话， 我都开始不相信， 不能再信了。
Then we cannot believe in anything God says.
等一下他跟你说， 我有讲过咩？ 我讲要给你咩？ 我有讲有天国咩？ 那怎么办啊， 那时？
Would he say, did I ever say that there's heaven? Then what are we going to do?
我们人会这样。
Man does that.
常常这样,
and man always does that.
神不会这样,
but God does not do that.
老实说, 我们对我们的亲人, 我们的爱人承诺, 我们老实说很多时候都是真的, 不是骗他的, 真的。
Many times our promises to our loved ones are real.
有时候, 以后我带你去环游世界啦, 以后我要给你做什么做什么啦,
I'm going to take you around the world. I'm going to do this and that for you.
我们有骗他吗?
Do we ever lie to them? No, we don't lie to them.
我们也很真的努力，开始非常努力的去做工赚钱。
And we work hard and we are very sincere.
就是要承诺我们对他讲的，要实现那个承诺。
In order to keep our promise.
要好好的爱他。
In order to show our love to them.
可是一场灾难。
But after a disaster.
一场车祸，一场意外。
After a car accident.
我们躺在床上。
We are lying in bed.
什么承诺都没了。
All the promises are gone. Because we cannot keep the promises we made.
不要说去做工赚钱啊, 连自己要吃饭来汤饭来吃都不能够了。
Not to mention working for our family, we cannot even feed ourselves.
所以我们以前讲的承诺, 那些全部我们做不到。 我们是信给他。
All those promises we cannot fulfill and we become faithless.
这也是一种很悲伤的事情。
This is rather tragic.
那有一些事情，他是跟你承诺， 简直就是骗你的， 也有。
But there are people who make promises in order to deceive you.
他根本就没有打算要承诺的， 就是骗你， 给你开心而已的。
They don't even intend to keep those promises. They want to fool you.
无论有心也好， 是无意也好， 我们就是常常这样失信啦， 但结果是做不到啦。
Intentional or not, we are often faithless. We cannot keep our promise.
但是他仍然是可信的。
But he remains faithful.
我喜欢这节圣经。
I love this verse.
这圣经也给我很大的力量跟安慰。
This gives me great strength and comfort.
也看出我们人的脆弱， 人的无能， 人的有限。
And it shows how fragile and limited and helpless we are.
当然也同时看出人的诡诈， 讲这些承诺的时候， 那种诡诈。
And it also tells us the trickery of men.
但神他不能背负自己。
But God cannot deny himself.
永恒的承诺。
Eternal promises.
谢谢你的耐心。
Thank you for your patience.
好，我们来唱诗。
Let us sing a hymn.
唱诗443首。
434。 Sorry, 434.
在那荣耀的国度。 我们请慕道者跟我们一起唱诗。
We invite our friends to sing along.